Hi friends, let's begin with why this enzyme is called as restriction enzyme. This is a bacterium. On the top of bacterium there is a bacteriophage. Bacteriophage are viruses that attack bacterium. Upon attachment, this bacteriophage injects its genetic material into the bacterium. Bacteria has a defense mechanism in the form of an enzyme which is called as restriction enzyme that cut this viral genome, making it inactive. As this enzyme restricts the replication of viral genome inside bacterium, this enzyme is called as restriction enzyme. Bacteria's own DNA is protected from this enzyme by means of specific methylation. At the end of this video, you will be able to understand what are restriction enzymes, different types of restriction enzymes, how restriction enzymes makes cut in a DNA molecule, and how ligases works as molecular glue within 5 to 8 minutes. Restriction enzymes are enzymes that is capable of making cuts in a double-stranded DNA molecule at unique sequences called recognition sequences. So this is a restriction enzyme Hind III, as you see, this cuts within this sequence. As this enzyme is capable of cutting DNA molecule, this enzyme is also called as molecular scissors, molecular knives, and molecular scalpels. The discovery of restriction enzyme actually marked the beginning of recombinant DNA technology. Hind II is the first restriction endonuclease isolated from Haemophilus influenzae bacteria. Here, second indicates the second strain identified of this bacterium, Haemophilus influenzae. Types of restriction enzymes. Restriction enzymes belongs to the class nucleases or nucleic acid degrading enzymes. There are two broad classes, endonucleases and exonucleases. As the term indicates, endo means these endonucleases makes cuts within the DNA molecule like this. Whereas exonucleases causes cuts at the ends or terminal regions or removing nucleotides from the ends. Endonucleases are widely used in recombinant DNA technology. Endonucleases, there are three types of restriction endonucleases: type 1, type 2, and type 3. Type 2 is widely used in recombinant DNA technology as it makes specific cuts within DNA molecule called as recognition site or restriction site. Examples include EcoR1, Hind III, etc. Magnesium ions are required for cleavage. Type 1 and type 3 makes random cuts, so rarely used in recombinant DNA technology. How restriction enzymes cut DNA molecule? So let's take EcoR1 as an example. EcoR1 is a restriction enzyme isolated from Escherichia coli R1 strain. So this endonuclease recognizes a sequence, a specific sequence, GAATTC, which is called as recognition sequence or restriction site. So this is how this enzyme makes a cut. So this is a recognition sequence. Whenever this sequence is there, this enzyme can make cuts within this sequence. This is the recognition sequence, GAATTC. This will make cut after G, and here it is before G, before guanine nucleotide. This site is called as recognition site. These are the characteristics of recognition site. It is often 4 to 8 base pairs. They are palindromic sequences, as you see, GAATTC from 5 prime to 3 prime direction. From here, 5 prime to 3 prime direction, it reads the same GAATTC. That's why they are palindromic sequences, often with 4 to 8 base pairs. They are called as recognition sites or restriction sites. Then cut patterns by restriction enzymes. First one is sticky ends or staggered cuts. Enzyme cuts that generate protruding single-stranded ends or extensions, as in the case of EcoR1. Let's take an example. The enzymes that make sticky ends are preferred in recombinant DNA technology. As you see, this is EcoR1 restriction site GAATTC. So it will make cut like this. So after the cut, there are single-stranded overhangs or single-stranded extensions. This type of cut is called as staggered cut or cut that makes sticky ends. Any complementary sequence to this sequence will form hydrogen bond easily, therefore widely preferred in recombinant DNA technology than blunt-ends. Then the second type of cut is causing blunt-ends. So this cut both strands at the same site, generating flush-ends, as you see like this in the case of ALU1. So this is a recognition site, AGCT. So it will make cut at this position after G. So this is after the cut. So it will not produce any single-stranded extensions. Therefore, the cut is called as blunt end or even cuts. The sticky ends are preferred in recombinant DNA technology. As you see, if the gene of interest is also having sticky ends and the vector is also having sticky ends, then it is very easy to anneal, as these single-stranded regions will form hydrogen bonds easily. That's why it is called as sticky ends. Now moving into ligases. Ligases are called the molecular glue in recombinant DNA technology, as it seals or joins two DNA fragments. Ligases are joining enzymes that joins DNA fragments by forming phosphodiester bond. The process is called as ligation. So these two DNA molecules are joined by ligases by means of phosphodiester bond formation. Now let us see how ligase enzyme join DNA molecule. These are the nucleotides in a DNA strand. As you see, this is the first nucleotide, second one, and this is the third one. Phosphodiester bond is formed between the 5' phosphate of one nucleotide of one fragment and 3' OH of another fragment. This two ester bond, called as phosphodiester bond, is formed by enzyme ligase. It requires ATP or NAD+ for its activity. Example is T4 ligase. Let me make it more clear. As you see, this is a single-stranded nick. So there is a 3' OH end and 5' phosphate region. So in the presence of ATP, this ligase enzyme joins and forming a phosphodiester bond just like this, thus joining the two DNA molecule or sealing the nick, single-stranded break or nick. In short, DNA ligase is the enzyme that forms, that seals the nick or single-stranded breaks by forming phosphodiester bond just like this. Hope you are clear with restriction enzymes and ligase enzyme. Thank you so much for your support. You are with biology exams for you.com.